Hello friends, this is Val Wolf from Durban, South Africa, Christ Healing Center. And I'm really excited to get this video together today to explain the manifestations of the Holy Spirit that is happening during our services and the great moves of God really in this revival time that we are experiencing at Christ Healing Center. You know, I love Jesus and I love being a vessel for him to flow in and through. And so I just want to encourage you to come along to one of our healing and deliverance services and really experience the true freedom, really, that only Jesus can offer you. Friend, are you in need of healing? Are you in need of deliverance? Perhaps you're traumatized going through financial setbacks, a sickness down the generations. You know, we have some wonderful testimonies from those who've been healed of depression. And there's so much hope in the Lord. Many people come to our services to be delivered from evil spirits of witchcraft that have really caused a lot of sickness and disease in the family line. And they get instantly set free by the power of God in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. Friends, you could be suffering from limitations, disappointments, anxiety, thinking about divorcing your spouse. Perhaps you are feeling suicidal or wondering if there really is a solution to your problems. Some people come suffering from a spirit of lust or anger. Friends, Jesus is the answer to every need that we have here on earth. Jesus paid an awesome price on the cross to bring about freedom and healing for us, both emotionally and spiritually. Most importantly, he desires a relationship with us, his children. I want to speak to you briefly today about the manifestations that are happening here at Christ Healing Center. You know, when you plan to go to a church that will transform you, that will change you, prosper you, and deliver you, there will be many who will really caution you against us. And that's really normal. As it happened in the Bible to Jesus, it happens to us too. Praise the Lord. In John 14, verses 12, it says, "Most assuredly, I say unto you, he who believes in me, the works that I do, he will do also. And greater works than these he will do, because I go to be with my Father." Now, friends, many people have seen the wonderful miracles, the signs and the wonders. You've watched the testimonies of what Jesus is doing here. You know, Jesus was rebuked and told to get out of the town for healing a man who had a mental illness by the tombs. So when you're cautioned against us, use your own discernment, friends. Have an independent mind. Don't listen to others, but rather go to the Word of God. Let the Word of God be your instruction and seek the truth out for yourself. You'll see that this is from God as demonstrated in the Gospels and the Book of Acts. And I want to show you some scriptures shortly to confirm this and that Jesus is indeed the same yesterday, today, and forever. Christ Healing Center is a Book of Acts church. Yes, there are manifestations and the demonstration of the Holy Spirit. Jesus had them and we have them too. And we're not ashamed really of the gospel of Jesus Christ. I welcome the Holy Spirit to move freely in our services. And there are many manifestations of evil spirits in the Bible, from seizures to twirling and falling down, being thrown around, really, and foaming at the mouth, screaming and falling out. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Ay, ay, ay. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Hey, isn't that wonderful? Really? Looser. Come out. Out. This doesn't happen all the time, really. But if it happens to you, don't become offended. They're not always manifestations. It doesn't matter whether people manifest or fall down or just really stand to receive prayer. Your healing is received by faith in the mighty name of Jesus Christ, with reference to Acts 3, verses 16. Hallelujah. Friends, here are a few examples. Now, there was a man with an unclean spirit in the synagogue, and the demon spoke out to Jesus. This is in Luke 4, verses 35. Jesus rebuked him, saying, "Be quiet and come out of him." And when the demon had thrown him into the midst, it came out of him, and it did not hurt him. Here's another one. Mark 9, verses 20 to 26. Then they brought the boy to him, and when he saw him, immediately the spirit convulsed him, and he fell to the ground and wallowed, foaming at the mouth. Then the spirit cried out, convulsed him, the spirit cried out and convulsed him greatly and came out of him, and he became as one dead. So they said, he is dead. They thought he was dead. And here's another one. Mark 1, verses 26. The impure spirit shook the man violently and came out of him with a shriek. Ah! You know, friends, this is normal church. This is what revival looks like. This is the book of Acts in motion. We're not to become offended by these manifestations or speak against God's word because we have not understood it. You know, in Mark 9, that scripture that I've just read, the boy passes out. It looks like he had died, but he wakes up and he is completely healed. The demon was the cause of his problem. This is the power of the Holy Spirit that really brings people out of darkness into life, brings them out of sickness into freedom, from poverty to prosperity. And when the demon comes out, friends, freedom comes. And then really, now it's up to the person to maintain the healing by keeping in the Word of God and establishing a relationship with Jesus Christ. Praise the Lord. You know, friends, over and over again, we hear testimonies after deliverance that the people are healed, because deliverance brings about true healing. And I want to encourage you to come along for deliverance. Here's another scripture. In Acts 8, verses 7, for unclean spirits crying with a loud voice came out of many who were possessed, and many who were paralyzed and lame were healed. They were healed as a result of the demon coming out of them. Friends, that is so awesome. Here's another one, Luke 13, verses 11 to 13. And behold, there was a woman with her who had a spirit of infirmity for 18 years and was bent over and could in no way raise herself up. But when Jesus saw her, he called her to him and said to her, "Woman, you are loosed from your infirmity." And he laid hands on her, and immediately she was made straight. And she glorified God. Most important thing you'll ever do is to say, thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. There you go. Spirit of infirmity is cast out. Osteoporosis goes. Hallelujah. A sickness that is caused by a demon demands a spiritual solution. Friends, if you're offended by the movings of the Holy Spirit and how demons are cast out, you would have been offended by Jesus' earthly ministry. These are all scriptures that really prove that what's happening in our ministry here is of God. Now, friends, there'll be many that'll tell you that the casting out of demons is not of God. But Mark 16 says that these signs will follow those who believe. In my name, they will cast out demons. They will speak with new tongues. Hallelujah. That's why I teach healing schools to make disciples for Christ and teach others to do the same things that Jesus did. Well, you'll get the same results that Jesus did. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. This is his original intent, really, for his church, really, friends. We need to come back to the simplicity of the gospel. Praise the Lord. There are many who will try to gain acceptance from the world by looking for unbiblical ways to remain relevant in societies today. Some even become offended because it's not normal church to them. The Bible says that the things of the Spirit are foolishness to the natural man, with reference to 1 Corinthians 2 verses 14. Listen to the scripture. The person without the Spirit does not accept the things that come from the Spirit of God, but considers them foolishness and cannot understand them because they are discerned only through the Spirit. Many churches no longer worship God in spirit and in truth, and the grace of God's power is lacking. People are sitting in churches looking for a solution to their problem. But the church today is a far cry from the church that Jesus built. We must seek the Lord in truth and return to his original intent for the church. This you will only find in the Bible, friends, not in a man-made doctrine. God is wanting to restore this power back to his church, to every church. Hallelujah. Friends, there are many preachers out there that will charge for healing and deliverance. Now, if a deliverance minister is charging you for healing, please know that this is not God's heart. It's unscriptural. Jesus paid that price on the cross. At our services, we merely take up an offering for the ministry, just like any other church service, and everyone is welcome to come along, whether you give an offering or not, how much or how little. Really, it's between your heart and God. There are many blessings in giving into God's work, but that is really for you to decide. Friends, our ministry is run on offerings and donations. No one is pressurized into giving at all. The same is true at our healing schools. These schools I teach for just under 6 hours at a time. All we ask for is a donation, as we need to keep the ministry going and pay for the conference facilities, as we don't have our own property. We're currently using a school hall on Sundays that are really available for us to use. The ministry doesn't even have its own vehicle. Please see my heart, friends, in the matter. I'm more interested in seeing you get set free and be saved. But we really do need your support to keep going. Hallelujah. All deliverance prayers are prayed for at our services. Deliverance has become a major part of our ministry. We've seen people who have been to see all kinds of psychologists and counselors for many years, be on constant medication, get instantly set free, really, by just casting out a demonic spirit. I think of Jesus in Mark 5 with a man possessed by legion, and how Jesus had authority over them. And this is how we minister here at Christ Healing Center, the way that Jesus ministered. A deliverance session, really, that Jesus did, that lasted 1 second, one word, go. And a great counseling session that was just a few words. Go and sin no more, he said. Be it unto you according to your faith. And since faith comes by hearing, and hearing from the word of God, we must, most importantly, meditate on the word of God day and night. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. You know, many think that I spend absolute hours ministering to those who have received healing. But the truth is, all I do is preach the word of God and cast out demons like Jesus told us to do in Mark 16 verses 15 to 18. Because our fight is against powers and principalities, not flesh and blood. There's so much freedom, friends, when we act upon God's word, spending time in his word and declaring it out daily and really applying it in our lives is really the best counseling session one could ever ask for. I encourage you to share your testimony with us, to encourage others to receive from prayer received at our services. You know, there are hundreds of promises that really confirm that Jesus heals today in his word. And the assurance really that no good gift will be withheld from those that walk uprightly. His arm is not shortened or his power no longer available for healing of the sick. It's also very important to discover the roots of the sickness. That's why I encourage you to get hold of a copy of my book called The Healing Power of God. Many have been set free by reading this anointed book. It is available hard copy at our services or on Kindle as well. Even so, friends, there is some, and of course you will see it at every anointed healing and deliverance ministry in the world, where for some deliverance doesn't seem to come, but we always stand on the word of God, knowing that it is a great privilege for those who believe. Friends, having said all of this, we want to grow this ministry and expand what God is doing so that we can build a church and employ staff. Pray about blessing us on a monthly basis with your financial assistance. We can bring the gospel to so many more people out there in the townships. Just pray really about supporting our ministry. Spend time in prayer about this. Seek the Lord as you reach out to him in obedience, because many lives are being changed into an intimate relationship with Jesus. They're coming back, they're giving testimonies of what the Lord is doing for them at Christ Healing Center. Praise the Lord. Be sure to have a look at the testimonies to help build your faith to receive your miracle as well. Just be encouraged, really, friends. As we go ahead, we have healing schools here. We have a healing school coming up very shortly. And we are out there to make disciples of all nations. And it's really wonderful to see what God is doing in and through our lives and our ministry. And the amount of people who really just being absolutely set free. And most importantly, to see them coming back really so on fire for God. Friends, this life is all about Jesus. It's about his divine purposes working in and through us. Friends, I encourage you to make Jesus Lord and Savior of your life today. And I just speak a baptism of the Holy Spirit right now. A baptism of the Holy Spirit and with fire. Father, I just pray for the person listening to this videotaping right now, Lord, this recording. And Lord, I ask that your Spirit, Lord, would come upon them mightily in Jesus' name. I thank you, Lord, for a baptism of the Holy Ghost and with fire. Father, I thank you that you prepare them to come along and receive all that you have for them in Jesus' name. And Father, we thank you, Lord. We just speak salvation to those families out there, Lord, who are undecided at the moment, Lord. Help them to see that you are the way, the truth, and the life. Hallelujah. Thank you so much for listening to this. God bless you, and I hope to see you soon at one of our services and schools. God bless you. Jesus is our healer, he's our savior, and he's our mighty deliverer. We give him all the glory for what he's done and for what he's about to do in our ministry. For more information, please go to Christ Healing Center, www.christhealingcenter.co.za. Hallelujah.
Okay, hallelujah.
Right, there we go. So, every unclean spirit, name. Thank you, Lord. You just get cross at these spirits. Go. In Jesus' name. You devils, get out. Being in our lives, and we've got to break them off right now. You devils, I break your power and authority, and I command you right now, go. You will go. Spirit attacking her in her dreams, go. Go. Right now. Get out. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Out. Out. Get out. Right now. Go. Now, go. Thank you, Lord.
Go. Yes, go. Go.
It's bound. Be loosed.
Thank you, Lord. She's delivered. Thank you, Lord.
Out. Go. Go.
Destroying over his life. Go in Jesus' name. So this is the power of deliverance in Jesus' name. Okay, it's actually going. Thank you, Jesus. Father, thank you for his deliverance right now in Jesus' name. We thank you, Lord. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Lord.